Hello, and welcome to my little series on Christmas know-how. When you see this tree in the last of these five programs, it'll be finished. It's only just started. Now there, instead, is a Christmas goose. The kind of thing, you know, that the maiden aunt that you always have because she's lonely on Christmas Day, or some other elderly lonely person, says, oh, I can't eat goose because, you see, it does repeat so. Well, this way, it never repeats on anybody because you get rid of all the extra fatty substances, and I'll tell you exactly how it happens. You prod it all over. You think of somebody you've never really liked. How did that go for the moment? And then pick it up again in a minute. Prod it all over. Think of somebody you've never really liked, but you're too well-bred to say what you think of them, so you take it out on the goose and feel it stabbed all over. Then you put the rack back, and then, beastly job this, you dip your hands into thin honey, and you coat the goose all over. Now, what happens during the cooking time is that the surplus fat erupts over all those little holes and starts running down in rivulets, crisping the skin, doing its own basting, and you end up with a gorgeously crisp skin, which is part of the eating pleasure, but the fat runs down into the baking tin below. Only one word of warning here, and that is, I have put this, of course, in the booklet, like everything else, and all the different stuffings that you use for all the different birds. But I must stress that at half-time, all your cooking times there again, I use Gasmarp 5 for this bird, the one shelf below centre, in the booklet. You must empty the tin of its fat a bit, because it gets overfull and can be dangerous at the end of the cooking time.